do all of these paintings have in common? They were all painted by this young man. However, most of you would only recognize him as this man, Adolf Hitler. The Führer of Germany and leader of the Nazi Party. Hitler gave up his dream of becoming an artist to lead a different life, a life we've all learned about. However, his love for art never diminished. In 1938, Hitler developed a plan for establishing a great museum. It was to be built after the war to show Germany's greatness. Hitler's greed was unlimited. Special commando units were already on their way throughout Europe. They were looting museums and private art collections in the shadows of the war. They were looking specifically for paintings for Hitler's museum in Linz. No major art collection was safe from their reach. The owners had to exchange their art treasures for their lives. After the official ending of World War II with the signing of the treaties, it was time to rebuild. Cities were destroyed, millions of lives were taken, and culture was lost. Thousands of pieces of looted art were destroyed during battles in the war. Following the war, the Allied forces sought to find and return the looted art to its home, whether it be a museum or a private collection. In the decades following the Holocaust, a worldwide effort was encouraged to identify Nazi plunder with the goal of returning the items to the rightful owners. Approximately 50%, or 110,000 pieces of art worth between $10 and $30 billion today, are still missing. It is believed that because there are so many pieces of art missing, that every institution, art museum, and private collection has some of them. This particular painting, called Portrait of a Young Man, was returned to the National Museum in Warsaw on September 24th, 2015.
Meet John and Janice Bob. The Bobs are art enthusiasts who have worked alongside artwork their entire lives. Their home is filled with sculptures and artwork, including a few painted by John's great aunt, famed Columbus artist Alice Schill.
My family have been collecting for a couple of generations.
In the Bob's living room sits a sculpture of the goddess Astarte that originated in Cyprus around 500 BC. John and Janice Bob always wondered about the origins of the mysterious painting that hung in their dining room.
This one got by me. I didn't understand what I bought. Well, I knew when I bought the painting it was a beautiful work, and I loved it. I knew it was I felt that it was of value, at least it was of value to me, but I couldn't decipher the signature. Mm-hmm. And it was a real mystery.
Never did the Bobs fathom that the painting of the young man had never been theirs to own in the first place, even though it had been a part of their home for 25 years. But all that changed the day FBI agent Paul Zukas contacted them and shared an astonishing tale.
And I was walking my dogs down on the beach in Maine, our little town, and got the call, and my wife was volunteering at the Historical Society that day. So I packed the dogs up and went down there and said, guess who I had a call from? FBI. No, I was a bit shocked. I was taken aback. Well, I didn't think I had done anything reprehensible that they would be on my heels for.
The painting, known as Portrait of a Young Man, had been stolen 7 years prior by the Nazi army from a museum during the World War II invasion of Poland, then later taken by an American soldier as a souvenir and brought to the United States.
Everybody was stealing everything from everybody at the time. They were called souvenirs of war. So I think it wasn't altogether uncommon.
Over the years, Bob attempted to find out more about the piece, which had lost its backside labeling by the time he bought it.
This mystery had been hanging around us, literally and figuratively, for all these years.
John and his wife Janice brought the portrait to the FBI's Columbus Resident Agency.
It was a little intimidating going to the FBI office,
where they met with a member of the Bureau's art crime team and officials from the Polish government.
Hundreds of measurements that they would perform. They had certain templates that they would use to make sure that this exactly matched up with the painting that they had this photograph of.
And the other job was to verify that it was indeed their painting, which rather than a forged piece of art.
After a series of careful examinations, it was confirmed that the painting in John and Janice Bob's possession was indeed Portrait of a Young Man.
I don't think for us there was any question with our particular painting that we should keep it.
Well, if we wanted it, we didn't have to give it up. It is a very valuable painting and we enjoyed it. But we were more than happy to put it back where it to give it up, so and where it should have gone, where it belonged.
And in fact, we had already made up our mind before the meeting at the FBI office, because we had some friends over the night before for a little get-together, a little champagne toast.
It's a great piece.
At the rededication ceremony in one of the museum's White Halls, Bob sat at a head table wearing headphones as interpreters translated speeches by the Minister of Culture and the museum director.
There must have been 60 or 70 reporters in that room.
The U.S. ambassador to Poland spoke, as did John. News cameras flashed as they posed for pictures with Polish officials, the painting, and the FBI.
But this apparently, they made a big deal out of this because this was one of the finest examples they've had in their collection. Unforgettable experience.
Even the typically stoic FBI agent was emotional. Paul Zukas said, "It was probably the highlight of my FBI career. It was just such a privilege and honor to be there. You could see a piece of the identity of Poland, which that painting represented, return. It was like a lost child coming back. There was an electricity in the room you couldn't help but feel."
Gentleman from the FBI was following the internet, and there were stories in Israel and Germany and Scotland and England and all over the place about this. And then,
well,
again, we never expected
every major paper in Europe.
When we told the FBI that they could release our names, we thought maybe there'd be an article in the Dispatch on the Sunday art section or something. We never really expected it to turn out like it did.
We have a lot of other works here and in Maine, but that was one of our favorites.
Portrait of a Young Man found its home. Unfortunately, most of the other art looted during the Holocaust isn't so easily returned.
Paul Poland's getting lucky now. They're putting a lot of force behind it, especially when they had the FBI working for them along with the what was it, the Immigration Bureau or whatever. Anyway,
well,
but they've, for instance, the Louvre, the museum in Paris. Mm-hmm. Most everything in that collection. A good percentage of the collection in the Louvre is looted art. A lot of these things, there will be no restitution. They will remain in the museums they're in or in the collections they're in.
I would like to challenge all servicemen from World War II, their survivors, museums, and private collectors to scrutinize and vet your holdings. When there is an obvious theft, as in this case, follow the example set by John and Janice Bob and return the item, without question, to the rightful owners. Let's unchain the last prisoners of the Holocaust.